Today we're going to learn how to set up your own website, including a WordPress installation, using Reclaim Hosting. We love Reclaim Hosting because they are built for colleges and nonprofits, and their customer service is spectacular. So if something goes wrong at any point in this process, you can reach out to Reclaim and they'll get you straightened out. So let's get to it. Step one, go to reclaimhosting.com. Click on Sign Up to see the options for purchasing a domain. Step two, select Personal and then click Sign Up. Step three, select a domain. There's absolutely no difference in authority or meaning between the different common top-level domains like .com, .org, or .net. You can select any of them. But before you select a domain name, think about what you're trying to communicate. We hope you'll use this site for professional career purposes later, so think about what your URL is saying to potential employers or clients. I'd suggest using your name, like jillbrown.com, if you can. If you have a very common name, you might have to get a little creative because somebody else might already have that domain. Or if people tend to misspell your name, you might want to think of a way to simplify. Step 4. Purchase your domain. It's $30 for the personal plan for the next 12 months. By the way, after this course, you have absolutely no obligation to maintain your website, but in today's world, it's a good idea to have your own website to promote your own work or present a professional image to potential employers, clients, or collaborators. Step 5. Wait for your registration confirmation email. You might get two emails from Reclaim, one that's a welcome letter and one that's a request to verify your email. Both of these are very important. Do not delete these emails. You need to verify your email in order for your site to go live, and you will need the welcome email for important login information. It also has important information for taking your site to the next level if you get interested in that. We won't be doing anything with the SFTP server in this class, but you don't want to lose that info, so don't delete this email. In the email, with all of that information, though, you'll see another important link, the cPanel. So step 6 is go to the cPanel, just a shortened form for control panel. You can click the link in the email to start, but in the future, you'll want to go through the client area login. All right, your website is up, but there's nothing on it. So part 2, now we're going to actually put something on your website. If you go to your domain right now, it's not going to look very good. So we're going to install a blogging platform that you'll be using to create content this semester. That blogging platform is called WordPress. You have definitely seen WordPress sites before. A majority of sites on the internet are run by WordPress or something like it. You'll likely see at the top of the cPanel under Applications the word WordPress. So step 1 is to click on WordPress. This will bring you to the Installatron. Reclaim has made it extremely straightforward to install WordPress on your site. Click on Install Application to get to the Options page. Step 2, set up your WordPress install. The installation guide should look something like this. For this class, you're going to want WordPress to be the first thing people see when they go to your website. So you don't want anything in the directory box, but leave everything else in that section alone. Step 3. Adjust your settings. Scroll down to the Settings section. Here, you're just going to want to make a few changes to make it easier to get into your WordPress install later. First, change your administrator username to something you'll remember, perhaps something like your MasonNet ID. Then, change your administrator password to something secure that you'll remember. You can leave your administrator email as is, or change it to another email that you're likely to check. Your website title should not stay My Blog. Change it to something sensible, something that people will recognize and understand, like your name, for instance. Then change your tagline to a short phrase that sums up you or this class. Leave everything alone except for that, and then click Install. Step 4. Check to make sure everything worked. Go to My Applications, back up at the top of the Installatron. You should now see the WordPress instance that you just installed. The key thing to note here is the address ending in WP-admin. That's how you're going to get into the back end of your site to customize it and write your blog posts. Note that you do not have to go through Reclaim anymore to get to that WP-admin address. I'd recommend that you bookmark that address, and from henceforth, you can go straight to that link without going through the Reclaim site at all. The username and password are the ones that you just created a minute ago. And that's it. Stay tuned for another video about customizing your WordPress site.